Yay! Everybody always wonders why me and my kids go barefoot in the forest a lot. Well, we want to train ourselves to be able to feel the earth with our feet. This is a very good way to connect with Mother Earth and feel good, good energy from
I'm
her.
trying to get to these
But also, Nico, what
and then
else can feeling with your feet help you with? It can help you know what's on the ground. See, if I'm walking in the dark and I can't see, I can feel this smooth pine needles and leaves. But if I'm walking along and I start feeling something else, like these sticks and stuff, then I know I'm getting off of the path. Even if it's pitch dark, we can see with our feet if we learn how to feel the ground. Hello, folks. Jim Walking Bear here, the Plant Whisperer. We're out in the woods walking. Me and the kids are out here walking today. Beautiful woods. A lot of you know that I teach about herbal medicines, but maybe some of you don't know that I also teach about survival skills and self-sustainable living skills, which go hand in hand with the herbalism. Although the herbalism is my specialty, that's what I know the most about and focus on the most. And in this time, when we have a lot of changes taking place in the world, economic changes, political changes, lifestyle changes all the way around, and definitely earth changes in the weather patterns, earthquakes, solar activity, all of it is increasing dramatically. So it's quite important for people out there to be prepared and value these skills that people like me offer to teach you. And there's a lot of us out there. You search YouTube, you'll find all kinds of people that know all kinds of stuff about survival and sustainability. This is what I specialize in, and I'm trying to make a living giving this information to other people. I've spent many years and a lot of my time, effort, and money, thank you, into learning what I know. And it's good stuff to know nowadays. I mean, if something happened and suddenly you found yourself in a survival situation, would you know how to live in these woods? Any woods like this, in a natural environment, can you survive? Could you survive if you were dropped here with nothing but what's in your pocket on a daily basis? That's not that difficult to do. Everybody thinks it is. Well, come apprentice with me and I will teach you how to do that. How to feed yourself, how to create your own shelter, your own fire, and how to use the plants as food and medicine, how to make traps, how to purify your own water. You can make a water purification system out of natural materials, everything right here from the forest. And I can show you how to do that. I will be making a video on that one pretty soon. As well as a whole bunch of other skills, all about self-sustainability and survival. I also wanted to let you guys know that if you can't take the time to come and do an apprenticeship with me, which most people can. I mean, you know, that would mean coming here for 3 days to a week or even a month, spending time camping out in the forest and learning from me. And that's a lot for a person to do these days with everybody working their jobs and everything else. So I can also try to do this through an online video correspondence course. I am offering an online one-on-one herbal medicine course that involves video presentation and one-on-one video consultation. Also, we're planning a group herb class as well, which will be done through a website called Blog TV, which will have a video broadcast showing you hands-on woods activity and herbal medicine stuff. And there's a chat room that goes right with the show where the students can come in and interact with me and the show, and they can also use video and send us video clips and stuff. So we could theoretically have an herb class walking through the woods and also have that being broadcast online, working with another herb class in Cyberworld. So there's ways around time constraints and being able to come and actually apprentice here. Let's work together. We'll figure something out. I'm very reasonable with my rates. If you look around at other people that do this kind of thing, my rates are always lower. And I'm also open to barter and trade. We're always in need of food and different things that you need to survive. and I'm always willing to work with anybody. I want this knowledge to be available to anybody, whether they have money or not. Although, we need money. I mean, the electric company doesn't take barters and stuff. Neither does the landlord, so. Hey, you got it. You got it. I'm right here. Hey, Nico, right? Hold still. You see how the grass is all packed down underneath this pine tree? Packed down, and then there's a trail going out that way. This is where a deer laid down.
Oh.
Probably a couple nights ago, he laid down here for a while.
Come on.
Looks like there were two of them. One went that way, and one went that way. Yep, there's another bedding spot right over there. They were bedding down there. There were three of them, because there's another bed spot over there.
Daddy, let's
so there's signs that tells us where the deer are. So we could trap a deer here. We could hunt a deer here.
And Daddy?
In a survival situation. Okay, we'll take a break.
Oh, look! What is this?
That's a type of fern. It's all ferned out and spored out. Those are all seeds right on the top. You crush that top, it'll release seed. Yep.
Come on, Dad.
That'll let more seed grow next year.
Come on, Dad.
Okay. So please, get a hold of me, and let's learn together. Anyway, this is Tim Walking Bear, the Plant Whisperer. And I look forward to working with you. Have a good day, people. Go home.